Why do we still have passwords? Everyone hates them. They're hard to keep track of and hard to type in, especially on your mobile device. And they just don't work, judging by the all too frequent news of bad guys busting into this site or that app. More report, Apple to unveil two new iPhones and a watch. The private selfie comedy and TV pioneer Joan Rivers dies at 81. NBC News legend lost, making people laugh. Was Rivers' greatest joy NBC News death of Yoda? The old tree tells tale of US drought. NBC News two reasons they haven't gone away. First, it's easy for programmers to deploy a standard username, password setup. They more or less just push a button in their app building toolkit. Second, the alternatives. Well, they're not quite ready for prime time. Let's look at a few. Popular among subscribers, Eat Butter Fat. Time magazine cover. The second age of reason subscribe. Maroon 5 falls off the bandwagon. Are you smarter than a teenager? Biometric sign-in. This is the term for signing in with your fingerprints or iris scan or another piece of yourself. For example, the iPhone 5 puts it to good use with a fingerprint reader. But there's a big problem. If your password or your credit card is compromised by the bad guys, you can revoke it and get a new one. Your fingerprint? Not so much. Federated sign-in. These are those sign-in with Facebook, or with Google or Twitter, buttons we're starting to see all over the place. This is actually a pretty good idea. Big internet operators are very good at security stuff, and every app that does it is one less password to remember.